Recebi dia 30 de março mais de 30 jovens de Stanford, de MBA, e foi muito bacana porque foi uma troca de energias e eles pediram para eu explicar um pouquinho de novos setores, de o que nós estamos fazendo e mostrei, enfim, a paixão que a gente tem pelo Brasil e que aqui tem muito conhecimento.
So I'm Puneet. I am a second year MBA student at Stanford. I was really appreciative that Ike was able to speak to our group today. He spoke about a number of different things, and I think around nanobubbles and talking about graphene, and I think in the Valley sometimes, in Silicon Valley, we talk a lot about interesting innovations, but they often tend to come to a very narrow gap of different types of problems and different types of solutions. And what was so refreshing is to hear someone who's thought deeply about issues that extend beyond this sort of narrow space. And I think there's a lot of interesting work going on in Silicon Valley and the outside world, but to have someone who's so excited and putting real resources against actually exploring what's possible, it's just very inspiring and also intellectually, as a nerd, very fun to be talking about.
All right, hello, my name is Lucas Patton. I'm originally from Houston, Texas, and I'm a current student at the Stanford Graduate School of Business in the United States. We came today expecting to hear from Senor Batista information about his past, about his investments, about his finances, sort of using his biography as a map to him as a person. But instead, he framed the conversation as, here are three interest areas of mine, logistics, nanotechnology, and graphene. And let me describe them and show you how passionate I am. And let's use that as a way to understand me. And that was a very different take than we've had from a lot of other speakers who kind of go through a biography or just want to talk about current day politics. I was surprised in such a way. I think his talent came through in that enthusiasm. I myself am not a scientist or an engineer or a mathematician or a physicist, but he created in me enough of a spark that in the future I can imagine, oh, I want to maintain knowledge of graphene or maintain knowledge of nanobubbles or whatever he's working on.
Hi, my name is Madhu and I'm coming from India. I've studied in engineering there at one of the top colleges there and worked in India and Africa in a few ventures before. And currently a student at Stanford Graduate School of Business, studying my master's in business administration there. We're in Brazil to know more about what is Brazil beyond the carnivals and beaches and protests and everything's happening, to truly understand what runs Brazil. And I'm particularly interested in looking at what runs Brazil, looking at people like Ike Batista, who's self-made to this stage of success and to come to such influential stage. And I was very curious to learn about it. So when I come here, I was impressed by three things. First is how humble and honest and open he is. Like, there's no question that he denied answering. Second is, as I think about sort of what made him successful, I think it's a lot of that attitude having the vision, looking at what is an opportunity, what is something that's missing in Brazil, in Latin America, or in the world, what can change the country or a sector as we know, and come up with a business to work on that. A lot of the ideas from graphene to gold mines in Amazon, all of those are crazy ideas that non-normal people wouldn't be able to envision that. He was able to do that. And last is, I feel that we need more people like him in the world, because there are problems like graphene and big ports that needs visionaries like him, who has a lot of wealth to take all in and put that. Like, you can't do big problems with small money, or you can't do big problems with small brains or small resources. We need people like him to bring in to be able to put all his wealth in, to be able to put all his time in, to be able to get the best resources in the world from Germany, US, everywhere, China, India, and put it in. And I think we need more people like him to shape the world and to make it a better place.
Eu sou Isadora Kimura, sou engenheira, mas agora estou fazendo MBA e mestrado em educação em Stanford. Bom, não preciso nem falar o quão animada eu estava para essa conversa hoje. cresci ouvindo falar do Ike como uma pessoa visionária, como uma pessoa que tinha vontade de mudar o Brasil. E sempre acompanhei de longe, né, na mídia, tudo que estava acontecendo. Acho que desde as coisas boas até as coisas difíceis. E para mim hoje foi muito surpreendente, muito emocionante de ver, conhecer a pessoa. De ver uma pessoa muito curiosa, muito com uma capacidade de aprender muito rápida, de dar uma aula para a gente de assuntos que ele sabia em profundidade, mas ao mesmo tempo são tão novos, como o grafeno, como as nanobolhas. Eu acho que o que fica é que a mudança no Brasil, ela é possível. Eu senti muito otimismo e muito conteúdo nessa visão que ele tem de projeto de empresas, de projeto de infraestrutura que são importantes para o desenvolvimento econômico do Brasil, mas que também não é fácil e que exige quase um idealismo, um fanatismo mesmo para fazer com que elas aconteçam. Fiquei muito feliz, surpresa e acho que principalmente animada, né? Acho que tem muita coisa para fazer aí.